The exercise is it's a huge exercise with 13 participating countries with 57 vessels, approximately 20 aircraft, altogether 3,000 soldiers from about 1,500 from our international partners and the rest from Finnish Defence Forces. So the purpose is of course then to train the participant units to a multinational cooperation in a framework of a crisis management mission. One goal that is to train our own units to work in a multinational crisis management environment in cooperation with the partner nations. And secondly, which is also a very important issue to keep in mind, that we have our international amphibious task unit, which we will evaluate to a NATO NL2 level during this exercise, so that this unit can be from the beginning of next year in NATO NRF reserve pool readiness for the whole year. Well, that's actually the main objective in this exercise, to train the different kind of units from different kind of navies in a multiple scenario. And you have to consider that we have not only the naval assets here in this exercise, we have also Air Force, Army and Border Guard units and all the naval assets, from surface unit to subsurface units, amphibious units and naval air assets. So this is actually the main issue, to train them in to cooperation. This is the only way we can nationally also train our units in a multiple maritime environment, submersible units, surface units, air units. So this is for us a very important exercise. And you have to also consider that the planning process is also a learning process. So you can also draw conclusions that the learning process is beneficial for the possible operational plan. Personally, I think that this is a learning process also for me, to learn how to conduct this kind of a big exercise with multinational units. Try to also to lead the coordination cell, and maybe by this also learn a little bit how it would be in a possible international crisis management mission to lead a multinational unit like the MCC, what we have in this exercise.